Let's see if we can do something a bit more difficult. Let's set the f of t equals t. So let's get the Laplace transform. Never know how to do these curly braces properly of t. Now we do have our shorthand of doing that. That is going to be the improper integral going from 0 to infinity of e to the power negative st times t dt. So here I have the product of two functions of t, and I'm taking the integral with respect to that variable. In other words, I better use the power rule of integration here. I'm going to select, there's various methods of doing this, I'll do it longhand this way. I'm going to select this t as being u, which means v prime has got to be the e to the power negative st. That makes u prime equal to 1, and that means v should have been 1, negative 1 over s e to the power negative st. If I take the first derivative of that with respect to t, I'm going to end up with that. This leaves me with uv minus u prime v. So this is going to leave me with uv, that's negative 1 over s. It's going to leave me with a t, and it's going to leave me with an e to the power negative st, and that it goes from 0 to infinity. Remember, it goes from 0 to b, and I'm taking the limit of that. Then I'm going to have a negative improper integral, and now it becomes u prime v. That's why I chose t, because I could simplify it, so the new integral must be a bit simpler than the old one was. 1 over s, negative 1 over s is a constant, so I can bring that out. That makes this 1 over s. And I'm going to have e to the power negative st dt. Now, what is this? This is the Laplace transform of 1. This is nothing other, we've just done it, previous video. This is the Laplace transform of 1, and we know what the Laplace transform of 1 is. Well, this is 1 over s. So here I'm already going to have 1 over s times another 1 over s. You can do this whole thing again, we just did it in a previous video. So it's going to be 1 over s squared for these two. Remember, this is times 1. So that's the Laplace transform of 1, which was we showed 1 over s. Let's do this side, though. It's going to be negative 1 over s times, this is going to be t over e to the power st, going from 0 to infinity. So let's do that. That is negative 1 over s. So what are we going to have? We're going to have infinity over e to the power s times infinity minus 0 over e to the power s times 0. We're going to have that plus 1 over s squared. Now this is indeterminate form because I have infinity divided by infinity. I will have infinity divided by infinity, but remember, this wasn't actually, that was actually a b. That was actually the limit as b goes to infinity of, it was b over e to the power s b. And if I put in the limit there, it would be infinity divided by infinity indeterminate form, so I take independently the first derivative of both. That would have left me with 1 over s times e to the power sb. And if I now slip in infinity in there, as 1 over infinity, that's the 0. So that's 0 minus 0. This is 1. That's the 0. 0 times this is the 0. So it's just 1 over s squared. There we go. The Laplace transform of t to the power 1 is 1 over s squared. That is the Laplace transform of t. Remember, we showed before the Laplace transform of, we said 1, but that's the same as t to the power 0, is 1 over s. T to the power 1 is 1 over s squared. I think you can see where this is going. But we'll get to that, and we'll do some more examples next.